Hello there.
We've wrapped on season 3 of Educative Sessions and created a recap of all 30 episodes. Enjoy.
Data scientists are curious. They want to look for something. They want to search for answers. Whereas on the software engineering side, you have this passion to build things and create. So I would say that I was more on the like curiosity side.
And the realization was that in finance, everything is private by default. Everything that you work on is, you know, company secrets, and it's a very zero-sum view of the world because anything that I share might be stolen by my competitors. Whereas in tech, it's a fundamentally different kind of industry where we're encouraged to share. We'll get up on stage and tell an open source our code and tell our competitors our secrets in an effort to hire them.
I feel like it's important to have a junior developer mentality because you don't always know everything, and imposter syndrome is very common in this industry. And it's important. I think it's an important thing to have. It doesn't feel good ever, but always, if you always feel like an imposter and you always have a junior developer mindset, you will always be encouraged to find other ways. Like, is there a better solution than the one I'm currently thinking of?
The other level of that for me is that empathy. You mentioned the word, right? The empathy of there's an end user. What is that end user trying to accomplish? How are they going to use this? And if I can get into that mode versus how I might use this and design this for them, who is the final user as opposed to me, who's going to build it, test it, deliver it, and then move on to the next one.
Then some time ago, someone that has been guiding me throughout my journey introduced me to technical writing as something that can help me learn to code better.
Yeah.
And you remember, I always wanted to code better. I always wanted to like gain fundamental understanding.
But like basically learning, how do I interview better for a developer position specifically? Mm-hmm. So I like Googled like, what are kind of design questions? What's the process like? I found a GDC talk from someone at Ubisoft about like how to interview for design positions. That was actually pretty great as well. So I kind of went back to the drawing board and kind of come up with new questions.
The reality is, you know, user experience is actually your brand now, right? Because how many times have you used something and said, oh my gosh, this thing sucks or it doesn't work or whatever, right? That's because the user experience design is poor.
I really just looked around my house and I was just kind of just sitting there and I was like, man, there's so many chores and I got so much stuff I've got to learn to do and I got so much that I need to do, but there's just not enough time. And I was like, you know what? Let me start looking into coding. My bud's been telling me like I should get into coding. My mom's been telling me I need to get in.
I drew myself a 5-year career path. I plan to spend 2 years in front end, 2 to 3 years in front end. I also want to go into back end. I really want to know how those people think. Just don't wake up and give me an API to consume.
You know, I went on Reddit and I found out about this program called Ada Developers Academy. It's trying to get more diverse people into tech. So I applied for this program and it had it was very slim chance that I would get in. I think they only accepted about 5% of people at the time.
In academia, primarily you're trying to come up with something that is a novel, innovative solution to a problem. And that might take you 3 years, 4 years, 5 years of work to produce this paper. And to an extent, the pace does matter, but the kind of pace time windows that we're talking about are very, very long.
Three principles that my mentor at the time gave me. You've probably heard this before, like dry, don't repeat yourself, piss, right. Keep it simple, stupid, and Yagni, you ain't gonna need it. And they kind of drilled this into me, and every single code change I pushed got better over time, right? Like through the feedback I received, so.
So you could look at it and say, I'm gonna create a lawn cutting company. Well, there's 1,000 other lawn cutting companies. But what if you're the only lawn care company that, you know, uses electric lawnmowers and you service a specific region and you're, you know, in and out before 10 a.m. in the morning. That's, you know, that's what you're known for, whatever else, right? All of a sudden now you've created your new spot in an industry.
But I had to learn that not everything comes easily. And sometimes the things we end up enjoying most are the things that are challenging to us because they bring out the best in us. They challenge us, they force us to get creative and overcome. And then we're so proud of ourselves when we wrestle through. That's like, you know, it's the old saying, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
I only want to explain the complicated stuff. And I always try to achieve the next level. This is all what I do. And I started 24, 26. So you see, now I ended here.
Exactly. So you could hear languages like JavaScript, right? It's in the int number. No. Python. I heard that Python can also do this. I know C++ is the main thing, and Java could also take over the whole market. Right? So, conflicting.
Yeah. It's like no matter where you go in the world, you will still hear these kinds of debates.
And one time, I even broke my bass drum. So I was so playing so hard that I broke it completely. So first of all,
this was during the meetup that you actually broke
your
instrument.
And then one crazy night, starting at 10 p.m. and going till 6 a.m. or something like that, we moved all the data over and turned it on and hoped it would work.
Right.
It did.
I think my first experience with technology dates back to the days of Super Mario, where you play all of these games and all of that. I think Nintendo games and all of that,
I remember very vividly saying to my advisor, hey, I don't want to be in startups. I've decided to go into research. I want to become a professor. And after this opportunity came into, and we decided, okay, maybe it's a kind of an internship for a summer. Let's try it out. And I remember,
actually,
I
said, Mom, I wanted to know if I was going to continue going to school or if I was going to drop out of school. And then she gave me her word and she said that, my son, you're not going to drop out of school. I will do everything possible to see that you go through school.
Because when you're doing mathematical research, if you're lucky, there's like five people in the world that care about what you're doing. And when you're writing software, you really know every line of code that you write has the potential to actually improve the lives of a lot of people out in the world.
It took a long time for me to actually fill the form to have a session with you. I had to go and download a lot of the videos, the Educative Sessions, the previous ones. I had to download the videos and listen to the people like the ballerina who went into coding and some other people. And I was like, wow, these people are doing really great things. What am I also going to bring to this table?
Each time I felt like I could have a bigger impact in that new role, as well as my incremental learning would be higher and I would be gaining more in that new role as well. So that's kind of how I thought about the different pivots.
It's not easy, I must confess, I'm laughing and smiling about it, but I know the times I had sleepless nights, trying to juggle the two red eyes and all over. And sometimes I ask myself, oh my God, have I gotten myself into
right.
Our journey from there on was very nice. We learned a lot of things there, which we're supposed to learn outside that. But
I just wanted to be computer literate. For me, that's what I thought doing something with technology means, that you just have to be computer literate because it's important.
And you just have to realize that, you have to be kind to yourself. And you have to realize that pandemic is affecting everyone. It's just that your circumstances might be different from the person sitting in front.
First of all, today there is what's called Internet of Things. You might bring your toaster with you, and that toaster might be connected to the internet. And you never even thought about this. You know this famous joke about the toaster secretly says that don't show his real weight, he's eating too much, so let's keep it quiet between ourselves. Yes, that's the kind of joke, but it's also real.
But I just feel like in the next decade or so, more of that research will be more accessible to analysts, so that you can actually analyze how a person tells a story.
Hi there. Hope you enjoyed this Educative Session. Be sure to check out more on YouTube or on any podcasting app. And be sure to like this episode and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Happy learning.